And let me introduce one of the greatest actors in our time.
97년도 영화, 22년 전인데 저뿐 아니라 사람들이 다 충격을 받았죠. 그 이제 갱스터 조폭 역할로 나오셨는데 심지어 그때 업계에 실제 조폭을 캐스팅했다라는 설까지 나돌았어요. 너무 사실적인 연기를 하셔가지고. 네.
So Green Fish by Lee Chang-dong came out in 1997. It was already 22 years ago, and people were so shocked by his performances. He played a gangster in that film, and within the industry, a rumor went around that they actually cast a real gangster for that movie because he was so realistic.
근데 이제 제가 그때 First AD 조 감독이었는데 그래서 이제 그 너무 한번 이렇게 저 신비의 배우는 누구인가? 그래서 저와 연출부들이 이제 같이 작전을 짜가지고 뭔가 오디션을 하는 것처럼 핑계를 대가지고 한번 모셨어요 사무실로. 근데 실제 뭐 오디션을 하거나 뭐 연기 테스트 이런 게 전혀 아니라 우리 막 열심히 이렇게 커피 타다 드리면서 이분의 얘기를 한번 들어보자. 어떤 분인가 도대체 어떤 사람인가? 네, 그런 일이 97년 가을에 있었었죠. 네.
So at the time, I was a first assistant director, and I just really was dying to meet this mysterious actor. So the other ADs and I, we created this plan to set up a false audition so that he can come in and meet with us. Of course, it wasn't an audition at all. We didn't screen test or anything like that. We just made him coffee, and we were just eager to hear from him. And that was in 97, autumn.
Just two or three months later, he explode and he number three, the movie, title is number three. That movie is huge hit in South Korea and he become a huge star. And so, yeah, it was 1997.
I was just second time feature film director. And Song Kang Ho gave this very strong, very some energetic atmosphere on set. The first day of the production, first day of shooting, kickoff day, it was very unforgettable and interesting.
그러니까 뭐랄까 저 배우밖에 없었어요. 저 역할을 할 수 있는 사람이 처음부터 그래서 저분을 전제로 해서 시나리오를 썼었고, 그 시대의 어떤 얼굴, 한국의 얼굴, 또 그분이 가진 동물적인 유머 감각, 모든 것을 갖춘 분이었죠.
So from the very beginning, I knew that he was the only actor who could play that role. So I wrote the script with him in mind. He was the only person who could represent the face of Korea of the 80s. And also he has this animalistic instinct for comedy. So he's an actor who had it all.
그래서 뭐 감독 입장에선 사실 단순하죠. 연기를 잘하는 배우분과 일하고 싶은데 예. 너무 연기를 공포스러울 정도로 연기를 잘하는 분이라서 뭐 영화를 보신 분들은 아마 느끼셨지 않을까 싶어요.
So for a film director, it's quite simple. We just want to work with great actors. And Song Kang-ho, he's such a great actor that it's almost fearful just how good he is.
He was very nervous whenever I show him my script. So he's such a great actor. So
아니, 내가 쓴 스크립트가 마음에 들어야 될 텐데라는 불안감은 좀 있어요.
Yeah. If we reject the script, I will quit everything. So
wow.
There is no alternative. Only he can do this role.
So the actor who played Kyu Choi, he actually had a difficult time with that scene because he felt very strange teaching him a song, who's a much older senior actor,
yeah,
about acting, and that's something that I remember.
It's a situation, something like, for example, Ansel Elgort is teaching Al Pacino on set, kind of.
그런 면에서 저랑 그 송강호라는 배우 네 번이나 같이 작업했던 그 되게 잘 맞아요. 그러니까 막 해보거든요, 계속. 그리고 그 배우도 매 테이크마다 계속 뭔가를 다르게 해요, 즉각적으로. 그리고 저도 테이크마다 이건 이렇고 저건 저러니까 여차저차해서 이렇게 바꾸라는 식으로 잔소리하지 않거든요. 그냥 계속 다시 해보죠라고 하면서 뭔가 서로가 동시에 스파크가 딱 터질 때가 있고 그 서로가 만족하는 테이크는 되게 놀랍도록 일치해요.
So I've worked with the actor Song Kang Ho 4 times, and in that sense, we're very good collaborators because he just tries. He every take for him, he shows a different performance. And after the take, I never tell him he should do this because of this and because of that. I just constantly tell him, let's go again, let's go again. And some of those moments, we will just, you know, spark together. And surprisingly, we're always satisfied with the same takes.
The very first day, very first shot, maybe you already know, it was the moment of Song Kang Ho flies and drop kick the Kim Sang-kyung.
Yeah.
Of course, Kim Sang-kyung was, for him, it's a slightly traumatic experience because he never know what was going to happen. But actually, me and Song Kang Ho and everyone, we never said, we never planned, and just we just keep talking. Yeah, just yeah, let's do it. But maybe location is quite steep. Yeah, it looks quite dangerous. But yeah, maybe we need some realistic something. And then suddenly, in the very first take, suddenly Song Kang Ho flies.
야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야야
the switch of camera, and he surprised, but very smoothly he followed everything happened. It's actually some kind of momentary documentary kind of feeling. Song Kang Ho just did it, and then DP Kim Hyung-woo just followed them, and almost everything improvised. And then I shout, cut, and okay. Just one take in the first day. So every crew members, including our production designer, Yoo Seung-hee, they is also shocked. And suddenly actor flies and kick and blah, 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 and then cut, okay. It's done. And then maybe that moment, the first day, that moment defines the atmosphere and the style and the approach of the movie.
Each actors, every actor has their own rhythm or tempo. So actually he, Song Kang-ho, he always dominate the rhythm of the whole movie.
Okay.
Particularly for my actors, I tried to give them a lot of freedom. I would meticulously set the frame and the image, and I try hard to make them as comfortable as possible. I also encourage them to improvise, but mostly because they have to follow very complicated camera movements, they're always telling me that they have no time or leisure to improvise anything with the meticulous setup I put up.
그렇지만 송강호 같은 배우는 되게 영감이 풍부하고 많은 또 애드립을 하긴 하죠. 또 그 와중에도.
But actors like Song Kang-ho, he's always very inspirational, and he still manages to improvise a lot.
I asked Song Kang-ho, maybe you have to speak something in this moment after the dialogue I wrote. Maybe Park Doo-man, the detective, he has something to speak a little bit more. And maybe you can have some answer, idea, or some. So I pushed him. It was 2 or 3 days before the shooting, this sequence on the train track, in the tunnel. Maybe it was take 3 or 4, I remember. Maybe it was take 4. He did it. 밥은 먹고 다니냐? He suddenly speaks it. But crew members around me, the script supervisor and the focus fuller, they slightly laughed because it was very odd and strange at the moment on set. Actually, it's impossible to translate because even with the Korean audience, it's quite, we know the nuance of that dialogue, but very, you have many ways, different ways of interpreting. Even among the Korean people, is so many different meanings. the last day of we rock the picture, that take four came back and I fix it, and then 밥은 먹고 다니냐? It is end of the final cut. After that, some marketing people and some producers are very nervous about that. In that climactic moment, that dialogue is strange, and some it's maybe offbeat humor or something. And some people love it, some people are very nervous. But after movie releasing, that was the most all the audience select that dialogue as one of the most impressive, unforgettable dialogue, and it was improvisation of Song Kang Ho on set.
왠지 강호 선배님과 있으면 제가 영화를 찍으면서 더 과감해질 수 있고 더 어려운 시도도 할 수 있을 것 같고. 그럼 제 입장을 한번 상상해 보세요. 강호 선 그 유치한 관점에서 이제 강호 선배를 봤을 때
그 여섯 개의 작품을
강호 선배님은 뭐 이창동, 김지훈, 박찬욱 감독 이런 거장 많은 거장분들과 일을 하시고 미량, 뭐 박쥐 이런 어마어마한 작품들을 이제 그 틈바구니에서 제가 그치만 강호 형님의 대표작이 내 영화가 됐으면 좋겠어요 이런 말